I believe that symbol on the pedestal is the key to the door leading to the control center.
Use the artifact I gave you, Jean-Luc.
Oh, he gave me the artifact. Is that really him from the future?
Fascinating. The shape matches the symbol on the door to the Unity Device Control Center. Fascinating. Captain Penta. Fascinating.
Fascinating.
There is a force field across the door.
Use it? Then what happens?
It's impossible. Captain. That won't help now.
Huh.
I believe that symbol on the pedestal.
So that's how we cross.
That won't help.
Alright. I'm surprised he can't just float across.
Can you use the artifact to bring me across, Picard?
I don't know, can we?
Fascinating. Fascinating.
Should I be doing this?
I don't understand why you brought us across.
Trust?
We agreed to work together.
Right.
I had assumed that agreement was a compromise you made out of weakness. You had the opportunity to take the Unity device for yourself.
Pretty much, yeah.
Compromise isn't always a sign of weakness, Admiral. It's the basis of trust.
That is an unusual concept. I shall ponder it.
Advanced race.
We are near the control center.
The Unity device is almost ours.
Okay. Oh, this door. Okay, we came out of there. All right.
It looks empty in there.
This is where the key goes, obviously.
There's a symbol on the door.
What about all the other tests? We had a lot of tests to do. Just one? Alright, come on, guys.
Fascinating.
Fascinating. Stasis chamber.
Fascinating.
Stasis chamber and fascinating. Who's that in there? Nothing else to look at. Hello? What are you?
It appears to be some kind of cell or chamber. There is a being inside. What kind of creature is this?
Could it be they evolved from this originally?
I believe it is a Kabalan.
Kabalan.
Legends claim the ancient Chodak created this race with the Unity device.
Created the entire race? Wow. That's pretty crazy.
It appears to be some kind of cell or chamber. Perhaps the controls operate the chamber. Captain.
I can't actually talk to him.
The Unity device is almost ours.
That won't help now.
There's a door.
Fascinating. It's a door.
It's a door. Well, I don't have anything to do with anything. I can't, like, blast it open with the phaser or even analyze the thing.
It did not work.
Greetings, aspirants to the Unity device.
Huh.
I am your judge. Before you advance any further, you must each tell me why you deserve the device.
Okay, so this is another test.
The Unity device was created by the Chodak. It is our birthright.
Whoever controls the device controls the galaxy. The Garidians deserve it as much as anyone else.
Hmm.
I am here to make certain the Unity device is used for the good of all species.
What would you do with the device, Captain Picard?
I believe I would use it to play Parcheesi. Use for the good of all. Establish and maintain peace.
The Unity device should be used for the good of all.
What do you consider to be the ultimate good?
I don't believe there is one ultimate good, but I do believe that each culture, each individual being has the right to determine what is good for themselves.
Very well said.
What good can the Unity device do for Jean-Luc Picard? Perhaps make up for a father's disapproval, a brother's resentment.
Absolutely not.
What do you know about my family?
I know all about you. I know a cadet who betrayed the honor code of the Academy. I know a lifetime of regret for a love thrown away from fear.
And now you're just rubbing it in.
I was young. Those were the mistakes of a youth.
What about the mistakes of a man? I know the captain of the Stargazer, his ship destroyed, his dead crew drifting in space.
Right. We're not infallible, thus we should not have any control over this device.
I did the best I could. It was an unprovoked attack.
The crew of the Stargazer depended on you and paid with their lives. But that was a small matter compared to your betrayals of the Federation.
Well, he's right. We're not worthy to have this device.
Betrayals?
I know Locutus of Borg, who oversaw the destruction of 39 Federation starships and their crews.
Hey now. We still have some PTSD from that experience.
I know a broken man ready to give Ghul Madred the secrets of the Federation's defenses.
Wait, there are four lights, buddy.
Do you think you can use the Unity device to erase a lifetime of betrayal?
No, I have no intentions of doing so.
I wouldn't want to. I have never willingly betrayed anyone or anything in my life. I have acknowledged my failures, learned from them, and moved on.
Right.
That's the best anyone can do. Failure is an inevitable consequence of being human, and I accept that.
Admiral Brodnak, failure is what you fear most, is it not?
I'm actually kind of relieved he's focusing on other people now. Or entities.
I have never failed before today.
Oh, so you view this as a failure?
Of course, you never failed. You always took the safe, certain path.
Hmm.
I consider that a virtue.
You do not even know what virtue is.
Oops.
As master of the nine challenges, you condemned countless Chodak for the smallest mistake.
Chodak are not allowed to fail.
The challenges were meant to improve the Chodak so that you would be worthy enough to reclaim the Unity device. But instead of mastering yourselves, you merely mastered the challenges. You have wasted 1,000 millennia.
Well, who set up all these tests? Because whoever set up the tests, I mean, if it's him, has to be, you know, in a position of authority to determine who is worthy and who is not. Thus, the ones who set up the tests would be the most worthy.
Perhaps we have dealt with form before substance. However, all meaning resides in form. Substance is but chaff.
I mean, did those Chodak rebels set up these tests?
Captain Pantara, you come from a weak and puny empire.
Ouch.
Even though you've agreed to share the device with these others, you'd prefer to have the device all to yourself, wouldn't you?
I'm sure she would.
Of course I want the device for myself. The Romulans have always forced us to do their bidding, and we never had the power to refuse. Even the Federation assumed we were simple lackeys. We're the Unity device in Garidian hands. Everyone in the galaxy would bend to our wishes, for once.
Hmm.
Good. You admit your true motivations.
What?
You are the only one truly worthy of the device. It is yours.
What? No! Get her.
Picard, stop her. I cannot move from this spot.
You can't? Why not?
Pentara, what are you doing? The device should not be controlled by one government. The risks to everyone, including your people, are too great.
Why can't he move from that spot? Is he holding him or something? Then why are we not... Maybe Picard is being held. He's not moving after all.
You're a fool, Picard. I will not betray my people as you have. The device is mine, and I will take it. You heard the Kabbalan. I'm the only one worthy.
No!
You know that's not true, Pentara. This creature is trying to trick you.
Is the creature trying to trick her?
What's wrong, Picard? You can't admit a Garidian has beaten you. Well, from now on, the Garidians are going to command a little more respect.
That sounds a little foreboding.
You see where compromise has left us, Picard. You should have taken the Unity device yourself when you had the chance. Now this unstable Garidian has the power to lay waste to the entire galaxy.
I hope this isn't like a dead end here. She's in there.
It appears her pride got the better of her.
That is something we should both guard against.
And then there are two.
She is trapped in a stasis field. It is difficult to assess. It's a door. Fascinating. That won't help now. It did not work.
We can't use her up. Spit her out.
It did not work.
Well. I don't even know what we're really even up to. I've just been playing. Do we just head for the door? Well, now you can move from that spot. Why couldn't he move? Because I was in his way.
It did not work.
Now what? It was in here somewhere. Okay, maybe I'm supposed to go back this way?
Have to release me. I would not have done the same for you.
I actually really didn't know what else to do at this point. I was kind of stuck, so I figured release you.
We all make mistakes. The only way to improve ourselves is to make sure that we learn from them.
But have we learned from them?
The Unity device is almost ours.
That won't help now.
Okay. Now do I walk to the door? I don't even know. I'm all the way on that side. Oh, now we go to the right. Okay. I don't know if this is the right answer, though. A tower.
Fascinating. That must be the Unity Device Control Center.
So where'd this guy go, this being? With the malevolent voice.
I wonder if the tests are truly over.
Probably not. It's supposed to be three, right?
The Unity device controls are within that tower.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's walk to the tower. Okay. That's good, right? Weren't vaporized completely?
Congratulations! You have proved yourselves worthy of your species. The Unity device is yours.
Are you talking to just one of us or all of us?
Now that we've got it, what do we do with it?
We must contact our governments and inform them of our arrangement.
Right, and then if they refuse?
Attention! The Unity device has detected the approach of a Borg invasion fleet. Without intervention, it is estimated that the Borg Collective will destroy Federation, Garidian, and Chodak civilizations within 1.2 years.
This is another test, isn't it?
Use the control panel to select a response to this threat.
Yeah, I think it's fake.
We must contact our...
Does Pantera have anything to say? No.
The Borg threat must be dealt with immediately.
It appears to be some kind of manifestation of the Unity device.
Right.
It is difficult. It appears.
I sense this is a critical thing here, so let's just save.
It appears to be. This panel appears to control the Unity device.
It's a test.
Destroying their invasion fleet would force them to the negotiating table. As you said, Picard, the Unity device should be used for the good of all, even this Borg race.
Are you mad? The Borg don't negotiate, and they don't give up. You should know that better than anyone, Picard. We have to eradicate them.
Well, I'm leaning towards destroying the Borg fleet. I definitely want to destroy. Don't want to destroy the Borg race.
It seems that yours is the deciding vote, Picard.
Borg fleet.
This panel appears to control the Unity device. Fascinating.
Alright, Borg fleet.
We can wipe out their entire fleet at the touch of a button? This is too easy.
The Unity device must never again be used to settle petty political disputes. You have failed.
I didn't select destroy their entire race.
We can no longer hold on to. We are losing this place in time.
Captain, are you all right? The rest of the away team were beamed back to the ship hours ago. We're reading a massive energy surge inside the device. It seems to be phasing out of time.
Wow.
Beam me out of here!
Beam me out of here!
Do we have the captain aboard yet?
Negative. We have lost contact again.
We are encountering temporal distortion waves.
The energy buildup inside the device is critical. If we do not withdraw...
We can't leave without the captain.
Help! Plot an escape course, 50% impulse. Transporter room, keep trying to get a lock on the captain.
Are you leaving without me?
cannot escape.
It looks like they escaped, but without Picard.
Admiral's log, stardate 47204.2. We've lost contact with the Enterprise. A large temporal anomaly was detected near her last reported position. I fear that either the Chodak or the Romulans have gained control of the Unity device. I'm dispatching the USS Hood to investigate.
It's always up to the Hood when the Enterprise falls, huh? Luckily, I just saved. Definitely a bad ending. What if I choose eliminate Borg race?
Are you mad? The Borg don't make
it. It seems. Can it be this easy to wipe out an entire race?
The Unity device must never again be used to settle petty political disputes. You have failed. We can no longer.
I'm guessing we'd have the same ending.
Captain, are you all right? The rest of the away team were beamed back to the
Beam me out of here!
Guessing about the same ending, what do you call it, cinematic.
Destroying their invasion fleet. It seems that yours is the deciding vote, Picard.
Deactivate panel? Yes.
What are you doing, Picard? If we are to share power, we must make decisions together.
The prime directive of Starfleet prohibits me from interfering with the normal development of any society. The wisdom of that directive has been proven many times.
Yep.
You have chosen wisely.
Oh, thank you.
The Unity device must never again be used to settle petty political disputes. You have proven yourselves worthy. Step forward.
Aw, yeah.
Who are you?
We are the guardians of the device of Unity. We are one with the device.
Are you the Chodak rebels who sent the device into the future?
Yes, and others.
And as I suspected. Sounds like Marina Sirtis's voice there.
You seem tired.
We are weak at this time and place. But elsewhere in time, we are strong. Each member of our collective identity anchors a span of time. Without these anchors, the space-time continuum would tear apart into isolated fragments of existence.
Could be wrong, but sounds like Marina Sirtis's voice and possibly the voice of whoever played the part of Chancellor Dana talking together.
We need one of you to join us. To become one with the device, and establish an anchor in this time.
Well, I don't think we're gonna volunteer for that.
I will join them. It is my duty.
But we agreed to share power.
There is nothing to share. Our purpose is our own. We do not serve the purposes of others.
Well, is this a good or a bad thing? I mean, they are the rebels. They're not going to let him use it to destroy the galaxy, right?
What is your purpose?
You could not truly comprehend unless you joined us. Suffice it to say that in many places throughout this galaxy, there are rifts in the fabric of existence. It is our task to mend them and keep existence unified.
Definitely sounds like a worthy purpose.
Brodnak, Admiral, Master of the Nine Challenges, Bearer of the 15th Shell of the Chodak Empire, are you ready?
I am.
Okay.
Without your help, he who was Brodnak would never have accepted this union. You have our thanks. Farewell.
Well, maybe it was the voice of Marina Sirtis and whoever plays Brodnak. Now that I can hear it more clearly.
Captain, are you all right? The rest of the away team were beamed back to the ship hours ago.
Oh, yeah.
A massive energy surge inside the device. It seems to be phasing out of time.
Where are we?
Beam me out of here!
Okay, hopefully now a good ending.
Do we have the captain aboard yet?
Negative. We have lost contact again.
We are encountering temporal distortion waves.
The energy buildup inside the device is critical. If we do not withdraw...
We can't leave without the captain.
Get the captain!
No. Plot an escape course, 50% impulse. Transporter room, keep trying to get a lock on the captain.
Are we gonna...
Commander, we cannot escape.
This looks like it's ending the same. Okay.
Damage reports.
No serious damage.
Game's not over.
Minor injuries.
What about the captain?
We were not able to... Sir, I am picking up the captain's communicator signal.
Sensors are reading life signs.
He's okay.
Yay! Beaming that sucker aboard. Hooray!
Captain's log, stardate 47205.3. The Enterprise has weathered the temporal distortion caused by the disappearance of the Unity device. All that remains are questions. Brodnak joined the device to enable it to continue its mission, mending rips in the fabric of existence.
Cool.
If he fails, the consequences could be catastrophic, but somehow I feel certain he will prove equal to the task. I can't help but wonder, if someday the Federation is able to create another Unity device, will we also have the wisdom to use it well?
Who knows? Who really knows?
All systems operational, Captain.
Very well. Helm ahead, warp factor 2. Engage.
Taking it slow and easy, aren't we? Warp 2. Credits. So interesting. Brodnak definitely found a better calling than he originally had. Definitely must have been unexpected for him, but he took it on readily. And what's her name, Captain Pintara? Can't be very happy, but she's gonna have to settle her race's differences without the Unity device. So, yeah, interesting. Very interesting story. Great game. I thought it was going to have tough battles like in the 25th anniversary Star Trek game. Very happy that they weren't so. Anyway, next I'm going to be playing the Genesis game. So stay tuned for that. Hopefully when you're watching this, if you're watching it the day it came out, it will be tomorrow. Called Echoes from the Past. So thanks so much, guys, for watching. Hope to see you in the next Let's Play or any other future Let's Plays. All the voice actors. Interesting. Tree. Anyway, once again, thanks for watching, guys. Endure. Enduring. Grow strong. And make it sound.